If for every epsilon greater than zero, there's a delta greater than zero, such that the absolute value of x minus c is less than delta, and the absolute value of f of x minus l is less than epsilon, then the limit of f of x as x approaches c equals l. That's the formal definition of a limit. If for every epsilon greater than zero, there's a delta greater than zero, such that the absolute value of x minus c is less than delta, and the absolute value of f of x minus l is less than epsilon, then the limit of f of x as x approaches c equals l. That's the formal definition of a limit. If for every epsilon greater than zero, there's a delta greater than zero, such that the absolute value of x minus c is less than delta, and the absolute value of f of x minus l is less than epsilon, then the limit of f of x as x approaches c equals l. That's the formal definition of a limit. If for every epsilon greater than zero, there's a delta greater than zero, such that the absolute value of x minus c is less than delta, and the absolute value of f of x minus l is less than epsilon, then the limit of f of x as x approaches c equals l. That's the formal definition of a limit.